In the last 5 to 10 years, the popularity of used clothing, whether it's vintage or recycled, has skyrocketed, especially with young people, me included. Because of this, I wanted to explore what it is about retro clothing that has grabbed the attention of people my age, and whether it has a positive effect on the world. For me, reusing clothes gives young people a sense of being original and having their own style. As if you look around most vintage or recycled clothing stores, you can find a piece which really appeals to you, whether it's the brand, the colour or the cut, and you won't see anyone else wearing it. I also feel like people are drawn to the fact that it is very easy whilst looking through reused clothes to find a piece or an outfit which fits you and matches the style you want to pull off, as you have 40 or 50 years of clothing styles to play with. 90s fashion is what is most popular for people my age currently, as it is very colourful, stylistic and brand heavy compared to what you will find in most chain stores and online, which draws people in my age group towards it. To explore this more, I went out and interviewed people in my age bracket on their personal opinions on clothing to gain a more objective overall view of what people think.
Well, my favourite brands are like Nike, North Face, Huff, stuff like that, yeah, Reebok, Lacoste, Nike. Adidas.
Nike, Reebok, and Adidas.
Favourite brand? Whatever's going, really.
I don't really look into brands, really, if I like a piece of clothing. I'll just kind of grab it.
Well, I don't really go to, like, many actual shops. I do all my shopping online, so, like, Route 1 and stuff like that. Yeah, I go to some charity shops if I see something I like, but you know, not a lot, but mostly online.
Probably charity shops. British Red Cross is the way to go, really.
I like some vintage shops and like charity shops, but I mainly shop online.
I do like having a look through charity shops. I don't really have a favourite, like, wherever I can find things. Like, vintage shops are pretty cool, they're always really expensive. So charity shopping is always pretty handy.
Because the colours nowadays are a bit boring, they're a bit dull, everything's quite black and grey, whereas vintage and retro clothing is a lot brighter, and I just enjoy wearing brighter colours.
Secondhand clothes feed my ego. I don't know. There's just a certain kind of like character around them.
I think it's become popular mainly because, you know, a lot of people, especially in places like Cornwall, like the whole kind of skate and stuff and kind of look, and retro kind of matches that compared to the whole like North Face brand. Like, there is some obviously like older, like this is like North Face, but it's not really like, you know what I'm trying to say. It's not like I'm trying to be a roadman, it's like more. You know what I'm saying?
I think it's become popular because people like how it looks like in old photos and stuff from like the old days, and just kind of like it's just come back into trend. People like bright colours and like more baggy clothing and things like that.
I think there's kind of a trend like all over in kind of retro things, like obviously like film is coming back with like film cameras. Vinyl's making a massive resurgence. I think it's the same for like vintage clothing. So people are just maybe looking for something different.
In a piece of clothing, I look for it to be comfy, look nice, and suit me.
Comfort and colour. So if it's comfortable and it looks cool, there you go, that's all you need.
Again, just character. Like, if I see something, I think, oh, it's kind of different.
No, it doesn't. I care about the environment, but it's not something I think about.
Yeah, because like one of the main things that affects the environment is like overuse of fabrics and stuff.
Not particularly, but I guess I feel a bit better buying stuff that's already been used instead of buying something new.
Yeah, it does actually, definitely. there's like a hell of a lot of like shitty things that like big companies do. Like if you order, say you have like a pair of trousers that you order, and then you think, oh, I'm gonna order two sizes of this because I don't know which one's gonna fit. This pair that you send back is mostly just gonna be sent to landfill because it's more expensive to restock it, wash it, and repackage it. So they're generally just sent to landfill, and there's so many seedy things that big companies do like that that are just so shit for the environment.
The rise in popularity of charity shops and vintage stores over the last 5 to 10 years has been very apparent, not only with young people, but with all age groups, as many people are looking for a sense of nostalgia. There are many factors which have led to the increase of popularity, such as people losing faith in big clothing chains for political reasons, the adaptability of trends, the environmental implications, and the character and soul that comes with a timeless piece of clothing. The main vintage store local to the college is in Jordan Trail Town Centre, which was started by Nuala Paris in 1998 to share her passion for vintage and reused clothes before it became trendy.
So with vintage fashion, yeah, brand-wise, it depends on the era. So if you're thinking about 90s, you're thinking about, yeah, Carhartts, Dickies, your retro nights, things like that. Definitely like Champion, anything that the brands. Also, if you're looking at real 90s, NAF, things like that, they're really good brands. But going to the 70s side of things, you're looking at a very different world. So you got your Mary Quant in the 60s and things like that. So yeah, Alexander McQueen, anything that's kind of like a little bit out there, a little bit different. Yeah, I like to have a good delve. So I like to have a good rummage in the charity shops. I love a good flea market. Any sort of car boot sale that's going on, like I'll be there sort of having a rummage. Generally don't tend to buy new if I can, because I don't want to add to the unsustainable nature of fashion. So yeah. For me, it would be the cut and the tailoring. Even though I'm wearing baggy clothing, it's all about that different cut that they had back in the 70s and 80s and 90s especially. For me, it's tailoring and the cut and the style of the clothing. Definitely think it's due to one, people being more aware of the environment, more aware of sustainable clothing, making, reusing, and recycling things that can have a life back in them. And I think that's really hit home for a lot of people, especially in Britain. Ooh, something a little bit different, something a little bit out there. If it's, the cut of something can really create an amazing look, and patterns, colour, things like that. So yeah, that really draws me to it.
Clothes.
Massively. Yeah, 100%. Like, that is the one thing that's always playing in the back of my mind. Is this going to be in a landfill in 5 years' time? Mm-hmm. Is it going to fall apart? Like, to reclaim all these clothes and have a new lease of life in them is, 100% the best thing to do.
As I found out more about people's reasons behind buying vintage and reused clothes, it became very apparent that the environmental side of things did influence a lot of people. Because of this, I investigated how much the clothing industry affects the environment and how reusing clothes can make a positive impact on things. More than 15 million tonnes of used textile waste is generated each year in the US alone, which is gaining each year as the amount has doubled in the last 20 years. From the 15 million tonnes, only 2 million tonnes is recycled and 10 million tonnes were sent to landfill. Staying in the US, each person on average throws away 80 pounds of used clothes per year, and on average it costs cities $45 per tonne to dispose of which synthetic clothes may take hundreds of years to decompose. The annual environmental impact of households' clothing is equivalent to the water needed for 1,000 bathtubs and the carbon emissions from driving an average modern car for 6,000 miles. When clothes end up in landfill, they create greenhouse gases, so recycling them instead helps diminish the forces that contribute to climate change. Reusing the fabric in old clothes means less resources, both monetary and environmental, are wasted in growing fibre for new ones. Second to oil, the clothing and textile industry is the largest polluter in the world. After completing this documentary, I feel that whether people just want to have an individual look or the environmental factor influences their buying, I feel as if the rise in popularity of vintage and reused clothing can only have a positive impact on people and the world around us.